Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX was supposed to launch their third operational Crew Dragon mission today with the Crew 3 launch, but that was delayed. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, we can now expect Crew 3 to lift off on Wednesday, November 3rd at 5:10 a.m. UTC or 1:10 a.m. EDT. NASA posted a tweet on this. It said, launch update, NASA's SpaceX Crew 3 mission is now targeted for Wednesday, November 3rd at 1:10 a.m. Eastern Time due to a large storm system elevating winds and waves in the Atlantic Ocean along the Crew Dragon flight path for the October 31st launch attempt. SpaceX posted a tweet related to this mission with pictures of the crew. The tweet said, Crew 3 astronauts, SpaceX and NASA completed a full rehearsal of launch day activities. With Viasat trying to shut down Starlink, this article from Ars Technica was recently posted. It says, the Federal Communications Commission this week urged a court to back the FCC's approval of SpaceX Starlink satellite launches against a lawsuit filed by Viasat and Dish. SpaceX has won yet another contract to launch a satellite on a future rideshare mission. This article says SpaceX has won a contract to launch an Emirati high-resolution imaging satellite on a Falcon 9 rideshare mission in 2023. Looking at the stuff in Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. After stacking the Mechazilla launch tower, Frankencrane has been lowered. The chopstick catching arms on the tower were seen moving on their own for the first time. The booster testing stand is continuing to be worked on. The new wide bay construction is progressing nicely in the yard. SpaceX have recently received parts for a new crane with it already being assembled. These vacuum raptors were moved to the launch site for Ship 20. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, currently there is only a closure for tomorrow, Monday 1st. Here's the latest with Starship 21 being worked on in the mid bay. This aft section, likely for Ship 22, was seen being flipped. The B2.1 test tank was moved and placed inside the testing structure. Work has been continuing on Super Heavy Booster 4 to prepare it for testing. Work continues on the metal heat shield structure around Booster 4's engines. As always, to finish up our Sunday video, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Like usual, I have to say thank you to both Mary or Boca Chica Gal and Nick Ansuini for both being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.